our music history series, bringing you the most memorable music moments from this week and previous years. On this day, way back in 1969, the Rolling Stones held White Police conclusions that drugs and alcohol caused the 27-year-old's death. Tabloid, no charges were ever filed. Additionally, it was during this week in 2002 that checking in, guys. Come back next week for another dose of music history with me, Jelena Jensen, right here on Crave Online. Hi, everybody, and welcome back to our music history series, where Crave Online and Penthouse team up to bring you some lesser-known stories and memorable music moments from this week and previous years. Back in 1969, Rolling Stones frontman and aspiring movie star another risky injury occurred on the same date in 1983, when sadly, August 19th marks the passing of a beloved musician. Thanks for checking in, guys. Come back next week for another dose of music history with me, Jelena Jensen, right here on Crave Online and Penthouse TV. Hi, guys. Welcome back to our music history series, where Crave Online and Penthouse team up to bring you the most memorable music moments from this week and previous years. On this date in 1962, a young Jimi Hendrix was honorably discharged from the 101st Airborne Paratroopers after breaking his ankle during his 26th and final parachute jump. It was also this week in 1979 when Sony first introduced the Walkman. Funny how you don't see Axl stage diving much these days. But then again, that does it for this week, guys. Thanks for checking in. Come back next week for another dose of music history with me, Jelena Jensen. Hey, music lovers. Welcome back to Crave Online and Penthouse TV's Music History Series, where we bring you the most memorable music moments from years past. Music fanatics are known for their feats of loyalty, but Aerosmith every name in the book before promising to bail out anyone who was arrested. As many as 28 of those arrested reportedly took the band up on their offer. And Aerosmith, moving on to more aquatic themes, it was during this week in 2006 that British singer Katie Melua entered the Guinness Book of World Records for playing to prepare for the show, which took place at the Melua and her band underwent extensive survival. A DVD of the event has since been released, but it likely doesn't do justice to the experience of watching a musical performance at the bottom of the sea. Finally this week, Beatles fans have loved the classic Revolver song, and the real Miss Rigby passed away during this week in 1939. What's interesting is that the iconic track wasn't actually written about her, but rather a fictional, whether by chance or inspiration. Eleanor Rigby's tombstone exists in the graveyard of St. Peter's Parish Church in Liverpool, a few feet from where. That's a wrap for this week, guys. Thanks for checking in for this chapter in music history with me, Jelena Jensen. We'll see you next week. Welcome back, guys. Our music history series continues today, where Crave Online and Penthouse TV team up to bring you the most memorable music moments from this week and previous years. This week in 1986 marked the first time in the history of the Billboard Hot 100 where the top three spots were held by female solo acts. Sin back these days from these three, as the size of one's backside and how they look in lingerie seem just as important as musical ability these days. Could you put a price tag on the amount of money you spent on music in your entire life? $32,000 on music during their lives, including real music enthusiasts were likely to spend far more, with an average of $89,000 spent in a lifetime. Given that the music industry has been in free fall in the years since the survey, the numbers are likely far lower for even the most hardcore music fans. But they're good numbers to have on hand the next time someone teases you for spending all your money to see your favorite bands. And finally, this week marks a rather gross anniversary for singer Billy Idol. The White Wedding singer dumped over six payback was delivered later during Idol's set t-shirts over their heads. One can only imagine what the fans thought that night. And that's a wrap for this week, guys. Thanks for checking in for this chapter in music history with me, Jelena Jensen. We'll see you next week. Hi, guys. Welcome back to our music history series, where Crave Online and Penthouse TV team up to bring you the most memorable music moments from this week and previous years. Believe it or not, there was a time when lip sync performances were outlawed nationwide. On this date in 1968, the Beatles recorded over the pre-recorded instrumental tracks to get around the British Musicians Union ban on lip-sync performances. For Hey Jude, the Beatles were accompanied by iconic refrains. It was on this day in 2005 that Kanye West. The show, which was raising funds for relief efforts, featured a superstar celebrity lineup and saw the unlikely pairing. Without warning, West looked into the camera and said, "George Bush doesn't care about black people." A comment that sparked a wildfire of controversy and renewed a focus on the government's delayed response to the tragedy in New Orleans. The following year, hundreds of Paris Hilton album mixes with improved titles such as Why Am I Famous? The sleeve picture also showed the reality star topless and with a dog's head. Sleepwalking can be deadly as Super 7. Quinn sleepwalked out of a first lane and smashing his heel. Left a sudden interest in window locks. And that's a wrap for this week. Thanks for checking in, guys. Check back next week for another dose of music history with me, Jelena Jensen. Hey, guys. Welcome back to our music history series, where Crave Online and Penthouse TV team up to bring you the most memorable music moments from this week and previous years. Last week's segment touched on the untimely passing of several iconic music stars. And sadly, the trend continues this week with another major loss in rock and roll. In 1980, beloved Led Zeppelin dropped. 2 months later, the remainder replaced the iconic Primal. 1985 marked a milestone year for populist interest in music, as superstars came out in force for the first alongside Johnny Cash, John Denver. The event had been inspired by Bob Dylan. Mermaid did just that, raising over $9 million. On the same day, 5 years later, in 1990, a spastic young drummer named Dave, he was instantly given the job, and the band would become one of the most iconic acts. 4 years later, Nirvana would dissolve after he stepped out from a hotly anticipated new album on the horizon. That does it for this week, guys. Thanks for checking in. Come back next week for another dose of music history with me, Jelena Jensen. Welcome back, guys. Our music history series continues today, where Crave Online and Penthouse TV team up to bring you the most memorable music moments from this week and previous years. Two legendary icons crossed paths in 1954, when a young and still relatively unknown Elvis Presley, Man in Black himself, Johnny, openly admired Presley's rhythm guitar playing and his showmanship. And this was most evident during a night foundation of the next seven decades of rock and roll. Sadly, the same date in 1978 marks a milestone loss in rock music. Keith Moon, drummer of The Holly Story. And it marked the last time he was seen in public. He played on all the Who albums from their debut. That does it for this week's Music History Roundup. Thanks for checking in, guys. Check back next week for another dose of music history with me, Jelena Jensen.